Hello, I'm Sean.
And I'm Lee.
And we play in a band called Idus Murder, and we're on Pit Cam.
Hey, guys.
Hello.
What's it like being back in Europe?
It's great. It's nice to be back. It's a little cold, but we love it here, yeah.
You've had two shows?
Yeah, it's the third one, so they've been great.
Oh, really? Yeah?
Yeah, last night was...
huge.
Massive.
It was like over 5,000, so it was pretty crazy to see.
And they come out early, so they get to see you guys as well.
Most of the time, yeah.
We're kind of lucky they we don't play till like an hour and a half after they open the doors, so it's enough time for everyone to come in. And
CJ left right after Christmas.
Yep.
Must have been kind of hard going out on tour with him just leaving. Or were you prepared?
I mean, not really. Yeah. It's a shame because it's, you know, a really big tour for us, but...
Definitely.
We've got Nick Arthur filling in. He's doing a great job. So, I mean, we weren't gonna not do the tour because we didn't have CJ. So, I mean, it's definitely different. But we're just keeping on trucking.
Mm. Yep. So, have you thought about how you're gonna find a new one? You're doing the thing that Northlane did with auditions, or?
Nah, I don't think so. We're just making a short list.
Yeah.
We got a couple of friends that we've approached, or they've approached us. So just sending out some instrumental tracks for them to record themselves on. And we're going to take it slow. I don't think there's any rush. It'd be nice to get someone permanent before the summertime and all that. But we don't really want to rush into it because, it's...
Your latest album is called Holy War, and it's been out for about 6 months now. What has the reception been like by the fans?
I mean, everything seems like it's been going pretty well. It's like they're all singing all the lyrics at the shows and stuff, and like we charted in Australia, which was pretty crazy. Like we got number 7 in the ARIA charts, which is
good for an extreme metal band.
It's just funny to us because
really, why is that?
It probably shouldn't be in there. It's a pretty kind of outlandish album to be in the ARIA chart, so everything seems to be going pretty well, and everyone seems to be happy with it. We're stoked on it, and our producer Will's stoked on it, so it's the main thing.
You did quite the controversial video for the title track. Tell me a little bit about that.
I mean, it's kind of based off the idea for the album art with the child suicide bomber and that theme, and even like the colors and everything. It kind of fit in with that, but we did it in Berlin. Yeah, last year. I mean, it's kind of, it's cool. We did it with a German company, Ambitious Films, they're friends. So it turned out great. And it was a little bit edgy, I guess. But I don't know, the internet didn't seem to, like it wasn't too much. We were expecting, you know, people to be like, oh, it's too much. And everyone's like, oh yeah, it's kind of, you know.
But you had to actually change the original album cover. Did that surprise you?
We kind of figured it would have came, like, it was pretty, you know.
It is a great cover, though.
It's a pretty bold statement, so it's, like, we were prepared for that, so we obviously had an alternate cover ready to go, but, I mean, we did it, so when we got the fold-out CDs, you can just swap the covers and then it's back to the normal one, so.
Yeah.
There's also a version, of, like, in the States that you can buy where it's just got a sticker over the bomb.
Oh, really?
So you just peel it off and... the same look.
This kind of controversy, is that intentional on your part, or is it just a natural result of your opinions and the way you express them?
I guess the stuff we, you know, we sing about, it's kind of, to us it's like, it's not, these ideas aren't too controversial for us. It's kind of like, for us it's a practical way of thinking, you know. So people, I don't know, sometimes I feel like they're just waiting for us to do something so they can make a story about it. But heavy metal, you know, it's always been a little controversial. And so it's nice, I guess, that people care enough to make a big deal about these things.
Yeah, you pretty much covered it.
Yeah. You're pretty outspoken about your views on religion, which is a big contrast to the whole Christian metal scene that you see in the States. You think this is an Australian or more Australian-European thing, or...?
No, a lot of American, like a lot of our American friends, you know, they feel the same way about these issues.
And I know we have the Acacia Strain.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, we're friends with Christian hardcore metal bands, yeah. So it's not like, I don't know, they just, yeah. It's
they don't hate you.
They don't hate us. We can look past it, you know, and still be friends. But yeah. For us, we're not really trying to be outspoken. It's just when it comes time to write lyrics and everything, that's the stuff that we're interested in and we believe in. Mm. And luckily we have a platform with the band to maybe spread some awareness in a way. Yeah. But yeah, I don't know.
You're on tour with Parkway Drive and Architects. They're also bands who are very open about their views on politics, yep, and social issues and stuff like that. Must be a pretty cool bunch to be around on tour.
Yeah, it's nice. It's strange though, because like never in a million years did I think I'd wind up playing in like a political, you know, band. Yeah. But it's just how it turned out, and these bands are pretty like-minded in that sense. Yeah. That, and the theme and the message that all our bands have is recurring. It's like, it's a similar kind of thing. It's just different styles, music-wise, I guess, and some sing about it a little more directly than others. Yeah. Mm.
Do you talk about it a lot on tour, like politics and stuff like that?
Just the usual stuff. Yeah. If we're drunk, we're like, sick of these people keeping the mandate. They're keeping us down. The man's keeping us down. But not really. It's kind of save it for the music, because you can have that conversation so many times, but it's not going to really change anything. So
maybe if you
maybe
reach a lot of
it gets frustrating after a while. Yeah. If you're always thinking about this stuff, you get a little bit depressed, you know.
So what do you have coming up after this tour?
We head home for 3 weeks, 3 or 4 weeks, and then we think we head out to America and do a headline run.
Oh. Weren't you just there?
Yeah, we a lot of keep busy.
Yeah.
But then, I think we're coming back here for the summer festivals. Okay. And then probably do another couple of tours towards the end of the year and probably start knuckle down and start writing another record and try to keep myself from going insane at home and doing nothing.
You get restless?
Yeah. You kind of run out of things to do at home, so just try to tour. Luckily, we don't have to, well, not luckily, but we're able to now, after a couple of years of relentless touring, take a step back and not tour so much, but it's kind of worked out well, because now we can plan our year a little better and allow for some personal time for the people that...
Planning to sing it.
Yeah, stuff like that. Yeah. But, keep busy, always.
Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.
You're watching Pit Chem, and this is where the Thumb War International Championship's going down, between Marcus and Phil from Science of Sleep and myself, CJ from The Artist Murder.
Can you compare your thumbs, please? It's about the same, so the chances are quite big that both of you can win, actually.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Here we go, Mike. Okay. One, two, three.
Go!